Namaskar children, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good at home. Children, please stay home and stay safe children. Now, coming to the topic. In this topic, I am going to teach you about singular and plural. What was the topic? Singular and plural. We all know what are nouns, right? Now tell me children, what are nouns? Name of a person, name of a place, name of a thing, or name of an animal. These are nouns. And these nouns can be of one or many. One or many. If we are talking about one noun, it is called singular. And if you are talking about many nouns, it is called plural. If there is one noun, we should say it as a singular. And if there are many, we should say it as a plural. Now, most of the nouns, to change from singular to plural, we use only yes. We use yes to make it as a plural. For example, boy is a singular. To change this boy into plural, if we add yes to that word, it will become a plural noun. C-A-T, cat. If we add yes to that, it will become plural. Cats. School. Schools. Bag. Bags. See, we are adding only yes to change this singular noun to the plural noun. But here we have some certain rules in this topic, where we can add not only the S, we need to add some other letters to make it as a plural. We'll see those words. If you follow those rules, children, it will be easy for you to remember what words can be added to that noun to change to the plural form. For example, the first rule, rule number one. Now coming to rule number one, in this rule you have to see where the singular noun is ending with s, ss, x, ch and sh. If the nouns are ending with these letters, you should add es to make that noun plural. We have to add es. Once see these letters, children. Pronounce these letters. What sounds you can listen? The sounds which snake will make, right? The snake will make these sounds. If the word is ending with these sounds, blindly you can write es. If you are unable to remember all these letters, you can blindly just remember the sounds and you can blindly add es to that word. For example, bus. Pronounce this bus. Can you see the sound? Yes. So you have to add es to make it plural. Next, glass. Pronounce it, children. Glasses. Add es. Now, fox. What we have to add after the noun? Very good. Yes. Foxes. Bench. Benches. benches, bush, bush, bushes, bushes, bushes. If you see these sounds after the word, if the word is ending with these sounds, what we have to add? We need to add es at the end of the word. Then it will become plural. Then it will become plural. And in this es, for this es, there are some exceptions, children. There are some exceptions. I'll tell you what are those. If the word is ending with, if the word is ending with O, if the word is ending with O, then also you have to add ES after the noun. You have to add ES after the noun. Noun or word, both are same, children. And here, see, for example, potato. Potato. See, the word is ending with O. So when to become, to make this potato plural, we need to add, we need to add ES. ES, we need to add ES. Tomato, the word is ending with O, so we need to add ES after the word. Tomatoes. And yummy mango, too is ending with O, so mangoes, mangoes. Rule number two, children, if the noun is ended with F or FE, if the noun is ended with F or FE, to change it, the noun to the plural form, it will, the F will be dropped and we have to add VE and followed by S and followed by S. If the noun is ended with F or FE, in the place of F, we should add VE and followed by S. For example, thief, thief, the noun is ended with F. And coming to the plural, it will change as, this F is changed as VE and followed by S. Thieves, thieves. Knife, knife. This noun is ended with FE and it is changed as knives, knives. Shelf, this noun is ended with F, and coming to here, what we should add, children, instead of F? Yes, superb, VE and followed by yes, shelves. Here, children, if the noun is ended with F or FE, to change it into the plural form, instead of F, we should add VE and followed by S. And rule number three. And coming to rule number three, if the noun is ended with, if the noun is ended with consonant, if the noun is ended with consonant and Y, if the noun is ended with consonant plus Y, what is consonant, children? Do you remember what is consonant? In alphabet, we have we divided the alphabets into two types, right? Vowels and consonants. We have five vowels. A, E, I, O, U. Other than these five vowels are called, the rest of the letters are called consonants, right? I hope you all remember that. Yes, consonant. If the noun is ended with consonant and Y, then we have to change that word into the plural form. We have to drop that Y and add IES to that noun. What we have to add? IES. For example, I'll show you the example, children. Study. 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 See here. This noun is ended with Y. And before Y, what is there? D. D is a consonant. D is a consonant. So in the plural form, how we have to write? Study. And Y will be changed as IES. studies, studies. Very Y, and before Y we have a consonant, so we need to add IES. Berries, berries. FAIRY, fairy. Y and a consonant. Fairies, fairies. IES to be added in the place of Y. Again, don't add Y, children. You have to drop that Y. Drop that Y means you should remove that Y, and in the place of Y you have to add IES. Remember this carefully. Study, consonant. D is a consonant and Y. You have to remove that Y. Instead of Y you have to write IES. Studies. And rule number 4. And rule number 4. In this rule, if the noun is ended with vowel, if the noun is ended with vowel plus Y. Already I told you what is a vowel, right? A, E, I, O, U, the 5 vowels. If the nouns are ended with vowel and then Y, you have to add just yes to that noun to change it into the plural form. What letter you have to add? Only the S. For example, boy. Here Y, and before Y what is there? O. O is a vowel. So coming to the plural form, what we have to add after the word? Yes, boys. T-R-A-Y, tray. See, Y and before Y we have a consonant. Trays. Just you have to add yes, children. If the noun is ended with vowel and Y, vowel and Y, you have to just add yes. And we have some, it's not a rule, children, it's not a rule. In nouns, we have some irregular nouns. We have some irregular nouns where those nouns doesn't follow any rules. Those nouns will not follow any rules, like man. And coming to the plural, it will change into men. For this irregular nouns, we don't have any tricks to remember easily, children. You need to memorize, that's it. You need to memorize. Child. Children. Child. Children. Mouse. Mice. Like this, we have few irregular nouns where they don't follow any rules. Just we need to memorize it like that. And we have one more kind of nouns where they don't follow any rules, like irregular nouns, but they don't change its form. But they don't change its form. When it is in a singular form, it will be same like a plural form. See the fish. In singular we call it as a fish. In the plural also it will be like fish. And sheep. In the plural also it will be sheep. Then how can we know that whether it is a singular or plural? You got a doubt, right? Now, how can we remember this, whether it is a singular or plural, means we need to check the sentence, children. In the sentence, if there is like a, this is a sheep. This is a sheep. These are sheep. By seeing this verb, helping verb, we can identify that it's singular and it's a plural. I hope you all understand, children. Please watch the video for 2 or 3 times and do the worksheets carefully.